Hi, my name is Gary Eckstein from organicweb.com.au. I'm a Mailchimp Pro partner and I provide Mailchimp services to some very large organizations, government departments, universities, right through to tiny Mailchimp users. And I've noticed that the questions are often the same. I get asked the same questions often. So I thought I'd create a video or several videos answering some of those questions that are asked very often by people that use Mailchimp. I'm going to go through four of those questions today, but if you do have questions you'd like me to answer in videos, please leave a comment and yes, please like this video too. Let's get started. The first question I'm going to answer is one that I get asked really often. What does cleaned mean in Mailchimp? And I'll demonstrate what's meant here. So if I'm in my audience and I view my contacts in my Mailchimp audience, so the question, what does cleaned mean in Mailchimp? I'm just going to scroll a little bit. If I go across, we have this email marketing column. So the question is, what does cleaned mean? What does this word cleaned mean in the email marketing column of an audience? Well, that's quite simple, really. It actually means that it's a broken email address. It means, in all likelihood, that you've sent an email to that email address, and it's come back as undeliverable, what we term a bounce. It's hard bounced or it's soft bounced. The server's been temporarily unavailable, for example, for a while. So it's a broken email address. It's marked as cleaned in our audience and we cannot send further emails to that email address from Mailchimp, even if we try to. In Mailchimp, we are not charged for cleaned email addresses, or they do not count towards our billing. Let me put it that way. The other values we can have in this email marketing column are subscribed, and we can only send emails to subscribed email addresses. Unsubscribed, the person's clicked unsubscribe. We cannot, even if we try to, we cannot send them an email. The last one is non-subscribed or an empty value. And that is where a person's been able to give their email address, but they haven't explicitly agreed to get email marketing. So for example, if you have your WooCommerce, Shopify, Magento, BigCommerce store connected to Mailchimp, your customers may come through to, or will come through to Mailchimp. But if the person, when they were purchasing or when they were joining, didn't check the box saying, I want to get email marketing, they'll be added with a null value, an empty value or a non-subscribe value. So we can't send email marketing to these people. So again, cleaned is a broken email address. We're only billed in Mailchimp for subscribed, unsubscribed or non-subscribed or empty email addresses. And just to keep in mind that these statuses are kept at the audience level, not the account level, the audience level. So if you have two audiences and the same email address in two audiences, you send an email from one audience and the person clicks unsubscribe, they will not be unsubscribed in the other audience. So you'll be breaking the law if you send an email to them from there. Okay, so that was what does a cleaned email address mean. The next question, what Mailchimp help and support is available? This gets a bit more tricky. Not really tricky, but I suppose it's an understanding. If we go to Mailchimp and click on pricing, so what help and support is available? If we click on pricing, we get different plans in Mailchimp. So we choose a plan which gives us different capabilities, whether we can create customer journeys, for example, or whatever. Depends on the plan, how many fields we have in our audience, depends on the plan we have. We then pay for roughly the amount of contacts we have in our audience. So what help and support is available? Well, if we go to the pricing, we then scroll down and go compare our plans. And we'll just wait for that. And now if I scroll down to the bottom, and hopefully I don't need to remove my picture that you're seeing of me, but if I scroll down to the bottom, you'll see that under the under the support section, we can tell what help and support is available. So we can see that if we're on a free account, we don't get 24-hour email and chat support. And we only, if we have the premium account, that's the only account that we can get phone support. I actually often get phone, maybe because I've worked as a Mailchimp sort of, or I've consulted on Mailchimp for a long, long time, but I often get phoned by people saying they're looking for Mailchimp's phone number or help and support. And only if you're paying for a premium plan in Mailchimp do you get help and support from Mailchimp. So in MailChimp, if you do want to get help, the best way really is once you logged in, let me just move the picture of myself just so you can see. Once I'm logged in, if I click the Help and Insights, the little question mark to the bottom right of the screen, and I'll just move myself back. And you'll notice that now we can either search for articles and their various different languages, Spanish, Portuguese, etc., German, French. And MailChimp keep the guides and tutorials up to date. They really are excellent at that. So the online chat and the email is available for all plans except, well, for all plans except free. The telephone is only available as noted for premium plans. So that's the help and support. Right, on to the next question, and then I've got one more after that. How many subscribers can people have in a free MailChimp account? Easy to answer, really. If we go back to the pricing page, so how many free, how many people can, contacts can people have in a free MailChimp account? Well, if I scroll down in the pricing page, you'll see here that you can have up to 2,000 contacts. You can have 2,000 contacts in a free MailChimp account, and you can send up to 10,000 emails. So if you did have 2,000 contacts, you could send each person 5 emails every month, for example. So that's it. The free account's great if you're just doing email marketing and you don't have too many contacts. Last but not least, here's a question for those people that integrate Salesforce with MailChimp. A question I often get asked, and I'll just read it quickly. Can I sync contacts between Salesforce and MailChimp? So can I sync contacts between Salesforce and MailChimp? The good news is yes, and it works really, really well. Just bear with me. And okay, so there's an integration, MailChimp for Salesforce. But let me just go back just to show where I am. So if you go to MailChimp / integrations, and then if you scroll down, that didn't work well, but just bear with me. Yeah, scroll down and enter Salesforce and click Enter. You can then click MailChimp for Salesforce. Very good integration. You implement this, and this is really important, you implement this in Salesforce itself through the App Exchange. So in Salesforce, not MailChimp. So you implement and configure the connection in Salesforce itself. What happens then is data will be passed, your contacts will be passed into MailChimp, audience or audiences of your choosing. Also, you can map fields across. So your Salesforce contacts will go across. And if you want to, you can enable your MailChimp contacts to go into Salesforce. They won't duplicate in each, but maybe you've got a sign-up form that people are automatically added to MailChimp. You can, if you want to, get them to go into Salesforce too. The reporting data will also go across. So it's very handy, works really well, MailChimp for Salesforce integration. And yes, you can sync both ways or just from Salesforce to MailChimp. It's your choice. And as I mentioned, you can sync across extra fields should you wish to. Those are the questions for today. Now, again, if you do have questions you'd like answered, please leave them in the comment section below. Please like this video, subscribe to my channel. I'm Gary from organicweb.com.au.